around like Gumby, right?
That's me. Yeah. I'm Amy Heemsoth.
And they do that by...
It's June of 2014 and I'm in Tonga, doing what I like to do best. I came to the South Pacific with scientists, working with the Khaled bin Sultan Living Oceans Foundation.
Khaled bin Sultan, and he's from Saudi Arabia.
The foundation is dedicated to preserving and studying the world's coral reefs. These critical habitats for ocean creatures are endangered now. We're trying to understand their complexities and figure out what we can all do to reverse this crisis in the oceans.
But we also take that research and we come and tell you guys what we're finding, and we share that knowledge through education programs just like this.
I'm the education director at the Living Oceans Foundation. And for us, education goes hand in hand with science.
And we started our mission over here in the Caribbean.
We're reaching out to nations that border on coral reefs to help locals understand their precious resource.
2 months ago, we were in Fiji, and now we're here in Tonga.
While in Tonga, we visited 18 different schools. We've developed a curriculum about coral reefs structured to U.S. standards. But it works for all students.
We set up in very remote areas. We carry a generator, and we really just set up shop. And the kids sit on the floor, and they're engaged in the images and the different things that they've never seen before.
How many people think that corals are minerals, which are kind of like rocks? Raise your hand.
About 95% of the students usually think that corals are rocks. And just being able to educate them that these are actually living animals that create homes to millions of other animals is really quite shocking to them.
Overfishing. Say it with me.
In all the places we visit, we work closely with community members, government leaders, and teachers.
The local liaisons step in and they translate those words that might be difficult. Some of the scientific words don't quite translate from English to these different languages that are being spoken.
But the problem is, if we take too much from the reef, do you think that's okay? No, because we're not leaving enough fish to eat. And we're not leaving corals for tourism.
And their students can pass this message along to their parents and their grandparents.
It can be any of those.
It's incredibly important, more so than maybe any other place, because all of these communities are relying on the coral reefs for protein and for food.
One more time. What's a coral?
Animal.
Malo alpito. What lives inside the animal? What does the animal create?
Definitely heartwarming to see the students respond. There's nothing better than teaching students this information and feeling like you're making a difference.
The kids in Tonga gave us a great send-off.